I heard a very funny case this morning. Usually, when couples get together for all the wrong reasons, that union fails. But for the couple I met today, what annoyed them might just keep them together.
Divorce court is now in session.
Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here today with LaCora Boyd and Andrew Boyd. The two of you have been married for 3 years. But you do not want to be married anymore. So, Mrs. Boyd, I'm just going to get right to it and start with you. Why are we here in divorce court today?
Because my husband is crazy.
Well, that'll do it.
He's a crazy man.
In what way is Mr. Boyd crazy?
He nags. He complains.
What's he nagging and complaining about?
About nothing. He thinks that I'm cheating on him. He wake up in the morning just complaining and yelling for nothing.
What's the most outrageous thing he's done when he's accused you of cheating? Is he looking through your phone? Is he?
Oh, well, my father had died in 2013. So all I did was gave a family member a hug. He had a problem with me hugging my family member. That's crazy to me.
That ain't real.
Mr. Boyd, did you get mad when she hugged somebody at her dad's funeral?
Yes, I got mad. But
why were you angry?
Now, when you hug somebody, you don't get to rubbing on them. You just hug and keep going, right?
I did not rub and hug.
I seen rubs, touches.
Mr. Boyd, it's a funeral. Her dad just died. People, Pat, hug. Right. You know, it's an emotional time. No one is getting sexual at the cemetery.
I understand. No.
Seriously, no.
I understand all that. But listen, if someone just died, what's up with all the touchy-rubby?
There was no touchy-rubby going on.
I mean,
on.
Touchy, okay, someone just died, right? Someone supposed to be some crying laying around. All I see is touching and rubbing. You know what I'm I didn't get married for that.
That is
I didn't get married for that, y'all.
Now, Mr. Boyd, you cannot tell me you don't know that people hug at funerals. Everybody hugs everybody at a funeral.
But they don't hug like that.
We didn't hug like nothing. I hugged like that was a family member.
No, it wasn't like that,
y'all. It's something in his mind. It's something that's going on in his own little brain.
You're halfway to crazy already. Keep going.
Something going on.
Keep going.
It's so crazy he need an SSI check or something. He needs something. Pills, medicine, he needs something.
They say I was saying. What I was supposed to do?
So then it was another time where a family member had came to visit us.
Mm-hmm.
And all I was doing was showing, you know, them ballroom. I'm dancing. You know, it's in Michigan. They call it ballroom. So he had a problem with me showing a family member how to ballroom. He accusing me of wanting them. I don't want nobody in your
You were
family.
Just dancing.
I was just dancing. Something casual, sexy, you know. That was it.
Wrong answer. Let's check it out, y'all. It ain't go nothing like that right there. Feel me? Now listen, you gonna dance. You gonna shake your booty and bend all over like that right there. Come on, you gotta be respectful about yourself.
I was
you got
not
six kids, you know what I'm saying?
I was in the privacy of my own home.
We got six kids, y'all. And listen, when I come home, my little daughter shaking her little booty now. You know what I'm saying? All my kids do booty dances now, and they ain't older age of three.
I'm supposed to be feeling something. I'm not quite sure what it is.
Well, check it out. Like, for instance, yes, like 2 days ago, we went to the store. You know what I'm saying? She was telling me, like, this guy was trying to holler at her or something like that right there. I'm like, okay, well, you know, you cute. People will holler at you. What, women beat him up or something? So she get crazy, start telling the man, I'm going to rob your mama and all this crazy stuff. The man tell me, listen, man, she need to go see a doctor. She's psychotic sick. So, you know, so that's why we here in divorce court.
Ms. Boyd, did you say that you were going to rob his mama?
I mean, because the guy tried to lie and say he didn't try to talk to me. So you trying to make me look crazy. So, yeah, I did tell the man I would rob his mom. But, I mean, I'm not going to actually rob your mom.
That is the oddest threat I've ever heard in my life.
Listen, I'm going to rob your mama. So you see where I'm coming from now. See, the body might look everything. She's crazy. I promise you.
Mr. Boyd, you said in your paperwork that you felt that you got suckered into this mess.
I did get suckered into it.
Can you explain how that happened?
Can I explain
happened?
To it? Okay,
please.
Check it out. Check. Got time for listen. Check it out. I was in my house just chilling. Feel me?
Yes.
Regular day. You know what I'm saying? I go to the store. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
And, you know, I see a pretty car with a pretty lady in there. So I'm looking like, oh, man. I need the car and the lady. You feel me? Uh-huh. But I didn't see nothing but her head. So from that point on, it was cute. So I'm like, okay, bet. You know what I'm saying? I was going through a thing at the time. So
I didn't know about.
So
I
rolled down my window. I was like, what's up, homie? You know what I'm saying? I got at her. So she was like, you know, we changed numbers and stuff. But I kind of figured something
went
right.
That is not how it went.
Let me get to my story now, because she interrupted me. I might forget.
Go on, Mr. Boy. Go on.
It went like this right here. You know what I'm saying? We passed the numbers. You know, I called her because I'm trying to get at her. She fine. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get at her. She ain't answer none of my calls. Ooh, just like that. She gave me a call a week later telling me her lights cut off. So, long story short, you know, I kind of liked her, so I was trying to impress her. So I went and paid $1,300 for her lights. You know what I'm saying? But I told her, listen, I want my
money. Was that his opening move, paying $1,300 for the lights?
And all I done. That's just one thing. I done 100 things. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to name one by one. Feel me? So I paid the lights. And I'm thinking, you know what I'm saying? You know, she got real friendly after I paid the lights. Like, too friendly. I'm like, we haven't even went out yet. You know what I'm saying? So.
Hang on, though, Miss Boy. You wouldn't return the brother's phone calls until you needed the light bill paid.
So,
and then you called him, knew he liked you, and you asked him for $1,300 for the lights.
I didn't know that he liked me, to be honest with you.
I was with a stripper. That's all I can say.
Whatever. I didn't know that. I didn't know.
How are you going to ask a man you don't think likes you for $1,300?
I didn't ask you. Well, he got something every time, though.
No.
He wanted his money back.
Right. Sure did. See, the thing was, y'all.
And I didn't have the money to give back.
She didn't have no money to give me. So I called. I went. You know, so I got female friends. You know, check me out. So I went and called a couple of my female friends. Listen,
that he didn't have sex with.
Listen, I'm like, you think it's cool?
Stop.
You think it's cool to have sex with this lady? They said the lady was deranged and crazy. I said, nah, this is special. I love that woman already. And that's where my problem is at right there. My life went, I ain't gonna lie, my life went uphill, downhill, back around, now I'm here seeing you. And Your Honor, listen, Your Honor, I really like this lady, but she gonna have to do something. She gonna have to, because looking pretty ain't enough no more. Because I remember when I was coming up in life, you know what I'm saying, woman told me, good looks ain't nothing, I need some money. Now I didn't understand that. Now I understand.
Now you understand what you mean.
Listen, I might ain't got no money. I got all the time in the world for my kids. Something I didn't have when I was growing up.
Uh-huh.
And all I wanted was to be a father I never had. And that's what I'm being.
And it's just controlling.
It's just that my wife ain't the wife.
To the wife.
Okay, all right. We're going to get to it.
Kids.
Okay. I got you, Mr. Boyd.
Yeah, hook me up. I'm always, I ain't nothing personal with her. I'm an angry man. I ain't got no money. I'm broke. I got no job. You know what I'm saying? I'm not. She ain't cook. I'm starved.
Divorce isn't easy. If you need help with your breakup, call toll-free at 1-877-311-2222 or visit our website at divorcecourt.com. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Divorce Court. I see that he's crazy. But I also see why you married him. I do. He's enjoyable.
Yeah.
He's entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
I've been having a good time so far.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't you tell me about what happened when you were in the car, he was driving to the store.
Oh, because I took a picture with a family member?
Right.
Okay, so he asked me not to take a picture with his family member.
Why?
I have not a clue. I mean, I don't know if it's jealousy. I don't know. He's deranged. I told you he needed a check.
So what happened?
So I ended up taking a picture anyway. You know, we just getting together. You know, I'm mm-hmm. entertaining the family. You know, we having a good time. I'm not used to stuff like that. So what I did was take the picture. He says, come ride with me to the store. I go ride with him to the store. He's driving my vehicle fast up and down these hills, feeling like I'm on a roller coaster ride. I'm just looking like, are you serious? Calling me every name. In the book.
Well, you're fussing at her, driving fast in the car because she took a picture with a family member.
That's all wrong. See, I like to drive fast anyway because you know what I'm saying? I like to drive fast.
Uh-huh.
Then my song came on. Feel me? I'm in love with a stripper. The song, it came on that day and I was speeding.
He listened to Project Pat. You don't even listen to Love with a Stripper.
Listen, that's a good song because I'm in love with a stripper. Don't complain. I'm dead serious, y'all. You know what I'm saying?
You see how he throw
hang
it
on,
up?
Hang on, hang on, hang on.
Were
you see, were you angry about her taking the picture with his friend?
Angry. I'm always saying, ain't nothing personal with her. I'm always, I'm an angry man. I ain't got no money. I'm broke. I'm a job. You know what I'm saying? I'm not she don't cook, I'm starving. I'm angry right now. I'm angry right now. I ain't hanging all day. I'm starving. Can you have something
to eat? You say he's unmotivated. You say he has a cleaning business, but he doesn't pursue it as if it was a serious business. Mm-hmm. Please explain that to me.
Okay, so I've been trying to help him get his license. I've been trying to help him get his GED. He always complains about that. I don't have my GED. I don't have my license. That's not my problem. You ain't got it. You better go get it. I tried to help you. So the cleaning business is called Boys Cooking and Cleaning Catering Services.
What is it called?
Boys Cooking and Cleaning Catering.
Boys Cooking and Cleaning Catering. Okay.
Yes. So basically, I need help with the footwork. He feel like it's too hot in the desert. He don't want to do it. You want to do that, but you don't want.
Y'all
I mean, don't you
believe,
don't want to do that, but you want to sit there and have a whole everybody in the neighborhood call you Jesus. You not Jesus. You ain't God. We need some saving and helping in our stuff.
How did we get in church?
I told you she was sick. Y'all, listen, they call me, hold on.
Jesus.
We're going to get it right.
Hang on.
No. They call me Young Obama because I keep all the peace together in the neighborhood. You know what I'm saying?
They call you Young Obama.
Young Obama because I keep everything together. You know what I'm saying? I didn't want
to. But you can't keep this together.
Who you think keeping together?
Me.
I'm babysitting all the kids.
You ain't got no choice.
She just woke up. Can I change diapers and everything? I'm tired of this.
He just started changing diapers. He just started changing diapers.
But I'm changing them, though. You feel me?
Just started with the last kid.
Hey.
Is it mine?
Hey.
See what I'm saying?
Hey. What about the cleaning business?
See, I'm about ready to just not even do the cleaning business because I'm cleaning my home more than the business. You feel what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Be honest with you, I got another company. I went on the lunch, unbutting her nose because when we got together, we supposed to be opening up a big brother and little sister, you know what I'm saying, program for kids out here. So I came up with Kids and Weapons and Attitudes, KWAG, you know what I'm saying?
Kids with weapons and attitudes?
Yes, but listen, now, you know your judge. Why do kids have weapons and attitudes? Mothers like her. Don't attend to them, leave them abandoned, all kind of stuff like that. So
that is so disrespectful.
Disrespectful?
Daddy, you was disrespectful.
I'm tired of being a mom and a daddy at the house.
Hey.
I ain't have nothing. You know, I'm broke. I mean, yeah, I'm married. You look good. I ain't got nothing. Sure. Get married right now.
Why not? If you would like your case to be heard on divorce court, call us toll free at 1-877-311-2222. Or log on to our website at divorcecourt.com. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Divorce Court. Now, Mr. Boyd, I want you to steady yourself, okay?
You said steady or study?
Steady.
Okay.
Just be calm, okay. Be cool, and I want you to focus on the question that I'm asking you, because I never got an answer. You believed you were suckered into marriage. I got something about the light bill, but I'm not quite sure how we got from the light bill to the altar. So why don't you please tell me how she suckered you into this union?
Okay, this is how she did, right? I don't know what kind of lady. Check it out. I'm at the house, chilling.
Right.
You feel me? I got all these girls in my house. I don't even need no more women. You feel what I'm saying? But I was going through a little thing. Straight up, depressed, drinking, and all that good stuff. And somehow a window had broke, and I ended up getting cut out the window. I went to the hospital.
You ended up getting cut?
Yeah, somehow the window fell. It's a long story.
The window. Oh, okay.
Yeah, the window landed on my leg and asking some stitches. Long story short, I went to the hospital. Me and my girlfriend at the time. And I'm in there chilling.
I thought I was the girlfriend.
I'm in there chilling, relaxing. You know what I'm saying? Finna get stitched up, getting ready to get, you know what I'm saying? Then somebody come in the hospital room, talking about they my wife. And this lady, I wasn't even married at the time.
You're not the one that took you there because her car couldn't even drive. She had a raggedy car.
Listen,
it wouldn't even make it there on time. You probably would have died.
Both of them took me. No.
I'm sorry. That wasn't funny. Yes, it was. hang on. So you and another woman were both dating him.
Right.
And
he
didn't know you had a woman. He got injured.
He got injured.
Which one of you took him to the hospital?
He got in the car with her. Her car couldn't make it past Gresham, the light. So he had to get out the car with me. so I can get him to the hospital. So, yes, I took him to the hospital.
See, she didn't tell the story right. See, I got out of the car with her to get in the car with her.
No, I just said that.
See, calm down for a second. Explain it. Take your time.
Now, you I just said that.
See, the car was going a little too slow.
So the muffler was coming off.
I told her to stop.
Couldn't even make it. It was doing like 10 miles an hour. He would have been dead for real.
I want to know.
I'm trying to tell you.
I want to know.
I was the ambulance.
How you got suckered
in
the marriage.
She keep on buttoning. That's why. I got suckered.
Okay, you're in the hospital. You're getting sewn up. Somebody walks in and says, she's your wife. Let's go.
Right. So I'm like, I ain't got no wife. You know what I'm saying? I got a girlfriend. So I see her. But you know, I'm like, how is you my wife? I don't even know you like that. So I said, you know what? I love this woman again. You know what I'm saying? I should have just ran out the hospital. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know that. I didn't know I was gonna go through all this. But then, like I said, we got together, and then we got on the highway, cause we was gonna, you know, leave Detroit.
Right.
And I'm like, we in the midst of leaving, you know, we something happened. We end up in Ohio. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, I got a text message. Do you want to get married?
I called you.
Hold up. Let me finish my story.
You guys were in the car, texting each other in the car together?
We're in different cars.
You were in two different cars.
Two different cars.
You were driving out of Detroit.
Straight to Mississippi.
To Mississippi. But you had to go through Ohio.
Yeah.
Right. And what happened in Ohio?
She texted my phone, told me you want to get married.
That's because he asked to marry me.
Hold on now.
At the time, I was broke.
I had no money. I ain't had nothing. No, I was broke. I mean, yeah, I married. You look good. I ain't got nothing. Sure. We get married right now.
Why not?
So we pulled over. I got my little tank top and shorts. So I ain't. This is my first time wearing a suit. Feel what I'm saying? I got on tank tops and shorts getting married.
That I brought for him.
Check it out. To me, it feel like it was a parole date. Because I'm saying I didn't get nothing.
We didn't have no honeymoon, nothing.
Period.
You just got married in Ohio, kept going to Mississippi.
Yeah, when we got it.
Well, I thought the honeymoon was going to be, when we got to Mississippi, we was living in a shack.
No, shack?
Hey, hey.
I didn't know it was a shack. I mean, it was a house.
That's your fault.
Okay. In divorce court, couples tell me everything about their relationships. Want to share your experience? Join the conversation on our Twitter page at Divorce Court. On Facebook, check out other fans and their intimate issues. You know everybody has something to say about love. What's on your mind? Mrs. Boyd, you're not going anywhere, are you? You love this brother, right?
I love him. If he get himself together and straighten up.
Well, what does he need to get? Tell him one thing he needs to change in order to remain with you.
Stop accusing me of cheating.
Girl, cheating. I think she crazy.
I should have cheated.
Listen, this ain't America. You should have. Oh, well, okay. You never caught her cheating, have you? Listen,
and
to
I
me.
Never cheated.
Don't even believe nothing she's saying. That's all a makeup game right there. Feel what I'm saying? Look at me. Do you look like I'm wearing a cheat? Wasn't cheating? Not.
Yes, you are.
No, look at me. Listen, when I go to the grocery store, women stalking me. Why I'm worried about what she doing? She's worried about what I'm doing.
You know why? You feel what I'm saying? Before, so that's why. All I want you to do is all I need you to do.
No. I never cheated before. See, the thing about it,
y'all.
Yes, you have. No.
I caught you.
Women were living in my house. How am I cheating?
You said they were family members.
They was.
Okay. And you was having sex too long.
You had a whole bunch of women and family. Let me say this. Let me say this. Hey. Mr. and Mrs. Boyd, I truly believe that you deserve one another.
You deserve one another.
I truly believe that you guys are going to leave here and stay together. And not only that, I truly believe it is best for society at large. If you two were to go home, stay together, and keep each other out of our way. Best of luck to both of you. This matter is adjourned. I think LaCora and Andrew got together and are gonna stay together because birds of a feather flock together whether they want to or not. Call us at 1-877-311-2222.